वॉट इज एविएटर फ्रैक्चर? एविएटर कौन होता है? फ्लाई करने वाले को एविएटर बोलते हैं. एव्स मीन्स बर्ड्स नो, जूलॉजी में. हाँ, व्हेन ही ड्रॉप्स डाउन देयर इज अ फ्रैक्चर ऑफ द नेक ऑफ द टैलस. बेबी कार फ्रैक्चर, व्हेन विल यू कॉल? Whenever fracture of the distal end of the humerus along with the proximal radius and ulna, all the three agar ho gaya to, it's called baby car fracture. What is meant by Barton's fracture, otherwise called marginal fracture? It is an intra-articular fracture of the distal articular surface of the radius. Are you able to see? This is radius, doctor, distal articular surface. Along with the dislocation of the radiocarpal joint. Together is basically called Barton's fracture. What is Bennett's dislocation? Favorite MCQ in entrance. It is an intra-articular fracture. Since it is intra-articular, what you need to do? Perfect reduction hona. Agar reduction mein thoda idhar udhar difference hai to arthritis aa jayega. So Bennett's is oblique intra-articular fracture of the base of the first metacarpal. Along with a subluxation of the trapezio metacarpal joint dislocation. What is Rolando's fracture? It is a complete extra articular fracture across the base of the first metacarpal is called. But this is extra articular, unlike? No way.
Changed,
eh? They said both are intra-articular. Then,
one is oblique, one is y. This is y. That is
oblique. Anyway, till now the current news I have. When you are in final year only, they changed. Eh? Is it? Oh, I don't know. But I need to suspect. I need to recheck. So, Rolando is extra-articular fracture across the base of the first metacarpal. Boxer, what is it? It is a ventrally displaced fracture through the neck of the fifth metacarpal. It is called boxer. Boxing me, fifth metacarpal. Raghav is also saying Rolando is intra-articular. Aisa ho gaya kya? Aajkal? Oh, I don't know. See, doctor, times will come where colis fracture will change its orientation from ventral to dorsal or dorsal to ventral. Better get the seat a little early. Good, good. Let me compliment you. Yeah. As a teacher, we have a lot of things to learn from students. As a doctor, we have a lot of things to learn from patient. So, thanks for correcting that. I don't know that. Is it? It is so minute that with MRI, everything, things have changed. Boxer's fracture. Ventrally displaced fracture to the neck of the fifth metacarpal. Then what is bumper? Comminuted depressed fracture of the lateral tibial condyle is called as bumper. Don't confuse with the dashboard injury. Dashboard injury means posterior dislocation. Then buttonhole fracture. There is a loss of bone in the gunshot wound is called buttonhole. So this is called chauffeur. Chauffeur means radial styloid fracture is called chauffeur's fracture. Chance fracture, there is a horizontal fracture through the vertebra, that is a body, pedicle, laminae, because of a sudden deceleration, which occurs usually in L1 or L2 is called as chance fracture. Clay Chevalier's fracture is a fracture of the spinous process of the T1 vertebra is called clay chevalier. Then colis is typically in the radial, distal radial ulnar joint at the cortico-cancellous junction is what need to be remembered. Whereas Smith is reverse, where the tilt is happening, ventral tilt and angulation. Whereas here, dorsal tilt and angulation is basically called the colis. Reverse is called as Smith. Smith hota hai agar flexion karke zameen pe gir gaye to. Suppose if you extend the hand and fall on an outstretched hand, that lead to coli. Cough, jada cough karne se, fifth to seventh ribs It is the callus in the rib with which you recognize the presence of fracture. So, 5th to 7th rib fracture is basically called cough fracture. Cotton's fracture is a trimenular fracture of the ankle, is basically called Cotton. Galeazzi, it is the distal third of the radius with the dislocation of the distal radioulnar joint. Montegia, fracture of the proximal tibia, proximal third of ulna with anterior dislocation of the proximal radioulnar joint is basically called Montegia fracture. The night stick fracture, isolated fracture of the shaft of the ulna is called night stick fracture. Then Gosselin's fracture, whenever there is any V-shaped fracture, as what you can see here in the distal end of the tibia, I think you are able to appreciate here, V-shaped fracture in the distal end of the tibia is basically called Gosselin's fracture. Then what is green stick? It is occurring only through one part of the cortex, the other part is intact and lead to bending, which is more commonly seen in children. Then Jefferson kya hota hai? Burst fracture of the atlas C1 is basically called Jefferson. Jones fracture, evulsion of the fracture of the base of the 5th metatarsal, as what you can see here, the 5th metatarsal is basically called Jones fracture. What is meant by hangman's fracture? Typically any traumatic spondylolisthesis occur at the C2, second vertebra, is basically atlas ke baad axis hota na, axis ka spine hota na, so traumatic spondylolisthesis of C2 is called as hangman's fracture. March fracture, it is the stress fracture in the shaft of the second or third metatarsal is basically called the March fracture. Then what is Pons fracture? It is a depressed fracture of the skull in case of infant. Infant may depressed fracture, as what you can see in the other view, is what need to be remembered. Then what is Pott's fracture? Bimalleolar fracture is two malleoli, lateral and medial. Both of them got injured, then you call it as Pott's fracture. That is the Suprabhatam. Kausalya, Supraja, Rama, Purva, Sandhya, Pravartate. So, you read them in isolation, it will be boring. You see an x-ray and read. But ultimately to memorize is, you need to have your own method. Now, about gout, what is true? We don't give allopurinol when it is acute gout. Why? Because allopurinol is xanthan oxidase inhibitor, which will lower the uric acid level. Any sudden alteration in the uric acid level in a acute state will precipitate urate stones. That we don't want. That is an acute state may, you will not start freshly allopurinol, is what you need to basically remember. What is Milwaukee's brace? As all of you know, Milwaukee is used in scoliosis. As you can see here, Milwaukee's brace. We have discussed in orthopedics one topic called, one video called Nuts, Bolts, Screws and Equipment of Orthopedics. So it is there in the online video library in orthopedics, you can review that. Otherwise a static subject which require more practical, actually practical application, I mean honestly speaking, orthopedics is completely physics and physics only, complete physics is orthopedics. Then osteoid osteoma, it typically arises from the all the three, cortex, periosteum, medullary cavity, from anywhere it can arise. Then doctor, osteochondritis dissecans 2011 Tamil Nadu PG, so you must be quite sure. It is the knee joint is the classical location. The medial femoral condyle of a skeletally immature child is the one who suffers from avascularity of the bone, which is then called osteochondritis dissecans. Brand's multi-tendon transfer, EF40 extension to flexion, four tail surgery, where it is basically done? Typically, Paul Brand is from which college? Christian Medical College, Vellore, is the highest center of innovation in medical sciences. Once upon a time, bone marrow transplantation means only CMC Vellore. Kidney transplantation means only CMC Vellore. Right? So, there's a beautiful video in YouTube on about the founder of CMC. If you get time, it will be very interesting video to watch. So, how she got inspiration to start CMC Vellore. So, doctor, extensor carpi radialis longus is released from its insertion and it is brought into the flexor aspect of the forearm, which is basically called EF4T, tailed tendon transfer operation of the Brand, is what you need to remember. What is meant by light bulb sign? This is called light bulb sign. Bulb ke jaise dikhai de rahe aapko. So, jab bhi aapko anterior dislocation ho jaye, it looks like bulb, that dislocated humeral head looks like, is what need to be remembered. Foramen sign, one question. Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Andaman, anywhere you go, you will have one question on brachial plexus injuries. Foramen sign kiske wajah se hote hai? Ulnar nerve injury mein, normal person, if you ask him to hold the book, the thumb will be normal like this, but the guy, there is a hyperflexion of the thumb which will occur. Why does it basically occur in case of the Foramen sign is a very important question. So, the IP joint of the thumb going into hyperflexion to substitute for the lack of the thumb pinch power of the index finger due to the paralysis of the muscle is basically weakness of the adductor pollicis ke wajah se. Normally, erectile pollicis is job hota hai. Kya hota hai? Agar aapko koi kitab ko pakad rahe to, thumb will be in a extended position. And pinch will be there. Pinch power will be there. But because the weakness of the adductor pollicis, adduct hone mein dikkat hai. So then what will, flexors will take over, which are not innervated by ulnar nerve. And that lead to development of hyperflexion of the thumb, which is then called the Foramen sign. Common MCQ asked in exam is, whose weakness is responsible for the Foramen? Whose compensation is responsible for that hyperflexion? So, these two points you have to be very clear about. Trimalleolar fracture is classified as what? Trimalleolar fracture is classified under what? Basically, if you look at the Lodge Hansen's classification, it is called as Lodge Hansen's classification. Khan is giving a compliment that your News for Medico articles are very good and your notes download being free especially is more good about News for Medico. In fact, today we have employed a couple of people to work on the website. Every day around 70-80 articles, high yield topic notes become uploaded along with YouTube videos which are supportive on the particular topic. Notes will be there along with that a collection of good classical videos which will make your preparation interesting. Everything you can browse it on your mobile phone. That is another beauty part in the reading room. And good important points are being mentioned MCQ. So, another 20-25 days may we will upload nearly around 2000 pages, each containing an article notes along with classical relevant, for example, osteogenic sarcoma. 5 to 6 classical videos about osteogenic sarcoma, YouTube videos, right, along with the notes, entrance oriented notes. So, that is the whole idea. So, our discussion board, discussion forum did not pick up so well because we do a lot of screening to avoid humbug news and the what do you call whispering rumors. To avoid that, there is a lot of editing done by the board. But you have a lot of knowledgeable content which will help you to upgrade every day for preparation. Even this Tamil Nadu PGE orthopedics questions along with explanations, we will upload it as a downloadable file for you in the download section tonight. So that's the point. Now doctor, this classification doctor, Lodge Hansen's classification, you need to go through the literature and review it. There are two classifications, Weber's and Lodge Hansen. Nowadays Weber is in more vogue, is what you need to remember. Now doctor, wandering acetabulum, where do you see wandering acetabulum is a very important question. Whenever there is any tuberculosis of the hip, musculoskeletal TB also is a very high yield topic of most commons in PG entrance. What are they? Most common skeletal TB is into the spine, and in the spine most common site, sorry, most common site of skeletal TB in children, kya hota hai? Hip. And most common infective pathology of the spine is TB. And what organism lead to pyogenic infection of spine? Staph aureus, which is not TB. Then in the spine, what is the most common area involved? Dorsolumbar segment is the one, and upper thoracic segment if it is pediatric population. And TB can be central type, paradiscal type, etc. So paradiscal is most common, and involvement of the intervertebral disc space. What is the importance of it? If the intervertebral disc space is involved, it implies infection. If the intervertebral disc space between two vertebrae is not involved and you are seeing a lesion, means metastasis is more likely. So whenever a patient is having severe back pain, CT spine was done, and you got the reports, first thing you need to look is the intervertebral disc space is involved or not. If it is involved, good news, because it is infection like TB and easily treatable. If it is mets only, you need to worry more. For nothing you need to worry, but you need to, prognosis become guarding. Now doctor, most common cause of the kyphosis is once more TB, and most common earliest sign whenever the TB of the spine is there, clinical sign, is paravertebral muscle stiffness. Normal persons may lumbar lordosis hota hai, isliye agar patient late gaye to you can pass your palm under his back. But you are unable to pass the palm under the back, means what? There is a loss of lumbar lordosis. Lordosis means what? Anterior curvature. Walking like a lord is called lordosis, anterior curvature. So when paravertebral muscle spasm is there, there is a loss of that anterior curvature. So agar wo late gaye to uske niche se agar aapka haath chala na bole to nahi chala sakte. So on the examination table only you will get lot of clues is what you need to basically look for. Now doctor, I leave the literature for you. There are lot of most common story available. This is the most frequent MCQ in Tamil Nadu PG, 2007, 2009, 2011. So Pott's disease is due to what? Pott's disease is due to TB spine is what you should answer like a parrot. Hydrated cyst agar bone ko ho gaya. This is a rare question. Don't go on reading about hydrated cyst in the bone. That 1 hour of your time is gone. But any entrance book, if it has to explain about this question, they will give 2 pages about hydrated cyst of the bone, including microbiology notes also on hydrated cyst. So don't lose into the jungle is what you need to remember. Careful surgical removal is what you need to do. It need to be surgically treated. Radical operation with wide excision. And they will never ask in future about hydrated system of the bone. Most unlikely topic. Blount's disease is a bow leg deformity. It is because of what? Typically, posterior medial part of the upper tibial epiphysis, if it get involved, then the medial part won't be growing well. Only lateral part will be growing, and that lead to development of typically the bow leg deformity. Tennis elbow, I think cheapest question on the planet. It is the flexor origin is called golfer, and extensor origin of the forearm becomes tennis elbow. And these are the common eponyms, doctor. 100% they will ask in exam. Great toe mein bunion aata hai, that all of us know. Bursitis of lateral malleolus is Taylor's, ischial bursitis is Weaver, olecranon bursitis is minor and student, and prepetalar is housemaid, infrapetalar is clergy, and bursa under presanserinus is called breast stoker's knee, it is called as those who do breast stroke in swimming, is what you need to basically remember. Then, what are the most common site of Salmonella osteomyelitis? Typically, it is the femur. Femur, Salmonella osteomyelitis is today relatively rare. Staphylococcus is there, TB is there. Other than that, examiner will not ask. At most, he will ask which is subset of population, like sickle cell can get involved in Salmonella. Other Salmonella osteomyelitis, which is the most common bone involved? A typical question. They will never ask in any other exam. But still, for your info, let me tell you, FEMA 26%, tibia 23%, humerus 21%, more likely answer is, most likely is FEMA is what you need to basically remember. Now doctor, compression of the nerve that passes through the supinata, what will it lead to? Typically, radial nerve is the one which is passing. So there is a reason, the wrist drop is what you will basically come across. Compartment syndrome, what is the last thing to appear after entire liquidation happened? Absent pulses, pulselessness is the last thing to appear. Putty plant operation, where do you see, do? Recurrent shoulder dislocation may, putty plant is what you will do. Six eponymous names which you should not forget, I didn't get time to add images. Dwyer's osteotomy, where will you see doctor? Varus of the heel in CTEV may, Dwyer's osteotomy, Dillwyn-Evans procedure, do you remember all those things? Then, Hauser's operation kaha karte, agar recurrent dislocation of patella ho gaya to, you need to do some amount of ligamental repair, which is then called Hauser. Then putty plat, Bristow, Bankert, they are all done for recurrent shoulder dislocation. Girdle stone arthroplasty is done for TB hip, and fracture neck of femur may, what will you do? Mayer's operation is what you have to fundamentally remember. Then Bateson's plexus, where do you find? Basically it's the Bateson's plexus which will carry all the metastasis from the abdominal viscera into spine, right? So that's the reason spinal cord. Most common site of osteosarcoma, hota hai lower end of the femur at the knee joint. Supracondylar fracture may, it is the cubitus varus, not valgus, varus is most common malunion leading to gun stock deformity. Then what is an important feature? Malunion is a feature, not non-union is an issue in case of supracondylar fracture of the humerus is what you need to basically remember. Dinner fork deformity. Only 2011, 12, 13, 14 papers are a pansal, thoda tough hai. Orthopedics, tough means not easy to propose kind of a questions. But 2010 is completely like a snow skating. It doesn't need discussion also, but still we'll discuss. Colles fracture is dinner fork. Oh, this is little cranky question. Actually bowler. Bowler, not bowler. It's a known question. Bowler's angle. So let us go through some angles, doctor, in PG medical exam quickly. I am happy to see around 30 plus viewers. Fractured neck of femur, you call Powell's angle. Fracture of the calcaneum, it is the Bowler's angle which is increased. Supracondylar fracture mein hota hai Bowman's angle. CTEV mein you will take the angulation between the first metatarsal and the remaining. Kite's angle hota hai congenital talipes equinovarus mein whenever adductus deformity occur. Neck shaft angle ke basis ke upar fracture of the femoral neck prognosis is determined. So this is a classical example where there is an alteration of the shaft and the neck angle. Corpse angle hota hai, agar scoliosis hai to you can be able to measure severity of scoliosis is the corpse angle. Perington angle hota hai, angle between the fracture line to that of the vertical line in the neck of the femur. In the case of the fracture neck of the femur is basically called the Perlington line, Perington line. What deformities do you see in rheumatoid arthritis? So you will see in fact all of them. There is a mistake, all ABCD are all the four are actually seen. So what is this called as doctor? Z deformity is what you see. Rheumatoid arthritis may radial deviation of the wrist with ulnar deviation of the digits. Z deformity. Another classical example of Z deformity. Swan neck deformity. PIP become proximal interphalangeal joint is hyperextended. Dip joint became flexed is called Swan neck. Bowdoinier is reverse. Flexion contracture will lead to flexion of the PIP and extension of dip. Is then called Bowdoinier deformity. Then there can be hyperextension of the first interphalangeal joint and flexion of MP joint, and Hammerstoss can occur. Wind swept deformity we have seen in rickets, no? It can occur even in case of rheumatoid arthritis. Then finally triple deformity, we will come to triple deformity down the line, is also seen in case of not only tuberculosis of the knee. Rheumatoid arthritis also triple deformity. Most severe form of epiphyseal injury that lead to development of growth disturbance kaha hota hai? Typically it is the four, more commonly type 4 epiphyseal injury. One kya hota hai? Only epiphysis will slip. Fracture through the epiphyseal plate become 2. Fracture through the epiphysis extending into epiphyseal plate become 3, and shaft and epiphysis crossing the plate become 4, and damage to the epiphyseal plate become type 5 is what you have to ultimately remember. Where will you use dynamic hip screw? Classically in intertrochanteric fracture, you can see this is a classical example. Dynamic hip screw this is called as. So dynamic hip screw is used in the case of the fracture of intertrochanteric fracture of the neck of femur. Then Sudex osteodystrophy. This is another very favorite question of the examiner, doctor. The two varieties called as CRPS1 and 2. Okay. So what are the differences between the two? So this is a patient whose lower extremity is showing complex regional pain syndrome. This is called as. So what is the fundamental problem in this? The patient has got a dysregulation of his CNS, dysregulation of autonomic nervous system, and that typically will lead to the development of the complex regional pain syndrome. There are two varieties, type 1, type 2. Type 1 was earlier called as reflex sympathetic dystrophy or Sudex atrophy was the name given. In this there are no nerve lesions. Whereas type 2 hota hai Kosalgia is the other name. They have a obvious nerve damage, then you call it as type 2. Then International Association has given certain clinical criteria to diagnose CRPS 1 and 2. I leave the literature for you, doctor. This session is too short for everything. Then complete wrist drop 2003 and 2008 ka Tamil Nadu PG ka archives, which you need to be sure. It can be archive of any entrance, radial nerve palsy. But nowadays examiners are not giving such simple questions, doctor. Where is wrist drop, finger drop? Now questions are going to be on image based questions. Rolando can be given. Rolando is intra-articular. We used to regularly preach Rolando means Romeo, Romeos are on road. Road means extra-articular. That's a school of thought. And since it is extra-articular, need not worry. You need to worry only about the people who are inside the home, not the fellows who go around the streets. So there is a reason intra-articular require perfect reduction. But we need to change the school of thought now. Luxadia, erecta, classically is what, doctor? Inferior dislocation of the shoulder joint is what you need to remember. So what is Tom Smith's arthritis? Typically, whenever there is a septic arthritis in an infant, then you call there is a breakdown, chondrolysis will occur. Then called Tom Smith's arthritis. How will you identify? The child will present with limp, unstable gait, shortening of the limb, and telescopy, increased hip movements in any direction. And Neisseria gonorrhea is the most common organism causing septic arthritis if it is adolescents and young adults up to 40 years who are sexually active. And non-gonococcal arthritis most commonly is due to staph aureus, is what you need to remember. What are all included under the triple deformity of the knee joint basically? Flexion, abduction, external rotation and posterolateral subluxation is basically called triple deformity. 100% you need to be sure about this question, doctor. What is second most common? This is too much, no? Most common itself is a horrible thing to remember. So, second most common become multiple myeloma. Osteogenic sarcoma. Now, 4 or 5 points about tumors. Tumors is another suprabhatam. Tumor means 20, 30 points must be there in your pocket. You must be ready to throw anything on the examiner, right? So, doctor, multiple myeloma is commonest if you take primary bone malignancies. More than primary, metastases are more common to the bone. Osteochondroma is the commonest benign tumor. Adamantinoma is what you see in jaw. Osteoclastoma, if you take genital tumor, one third benign, one third malignant, one third are frankly malignant. Osteosarcoma is second most common. Coming to Ewing's, most common malignant tumor of the flat bones is Ewing's. And malignant tumor which is multicentric in nature is also Ewing's, is what need to be basically remembered. And what comes to bones generally? See a lung in the male, see a breast in female are the most common tumors to come to bone. Non-union of the fractured neck of femur, kiske wajah se hota? Sab cheezon ke wajah se hota. Inadequate immobilization, inadequate blood supply, synovial fluid lead to inhibitory effect, anything can be responsible. Charcot's joints, neuropathic joints, one big list of causes will be there, doctor. Diabetes, alcoholism, cerebral palsy, leprosy, syphilis, spinal cord injury, myelomeningocele, blah, 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 big list is there. Which you need to remember. Yeah, this is a rememberable list because examiner's favorite question. Then which joint is the favorite joint of involvement in various conditions is another list, doctor. Very important list that you need to carry to exam hall. Mid-tarsal is the most common location if diabetic foot is there. Temis dorsalis, knee is most common. Leprosy may interphalangeal joints most common. Syringomyelia may shoulder and myelomeningocele may ankle and the intertarsal. Up to there you remember. Then what fracture commonly leads to non-union and also avascular necrosis very commonly? It is scaphoid fracture which is responsible. Low ulnar palsy versus higher ulnar palsy. Generally, where will you expect clawing to be more? Normal expectation. High or low? Higher lesion should cause clawing more. But actually clawing will be less if the higher lesion at the elbow is involved. Right? So, kyo hota hai vaisa? Flexor digitorum profundus is there, no? If the higher level may, if it is involved, even flexor digitorum profundus also is paralyzed. Right? Whereas if it is occurring at the lower level, then you have got the sparing. And that will lead to development of the clawing where the other muscles are basically paralyzed. So there is a reason clawing will be more when it is involving lower rather than upper, because the upper bay involvement of FDP, which is spared in the case of the lower lesions, is what you need to basically remember. Who is the father of hip replacement surgery? Nowadays lot of brothers are there. Right. So, because MS orthopedics ke baad morning one hip replacement, afternoon one knee replacement, evening one ankle replacement, and dinner ke liye one hind quarter amputation. So, you are a busy surgeon. So, some surgeons operate 10-20 replacements also one day. Right. So, then who is their father? So, doctor, it is Sir John Chanley in 1960, first developed the procedure of total joint replacement. It helped so many people. Nowadays, tuck, 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 one metal is hitting another metal, people walk like they will start acting in movies at 70 also, very famous movies. Sir John Chanley. Then first metallic hip replacement is Austin Moore. Nicholas Sandry is the one who termed orthopedics. Originally it was pedics means pediatric surgery. Then John Hunter described fracture healing. Antonio Matheson has invented plaster of Paris. And McEwen first performed osteotomy and bone grafting. Those days they used to do lot of things. McEwen is also known in case of McEwen sign, forensic medicine may. So there is a reason there were lot of things to discover and more enjoyable life. Nowadays everything is known to the kids at their 4th or 5th year only. Not MBBS, school. So, what is seen in rickets? All these are seen except the widening of joint space. Cupping will be there. Cupping of metaphyseal space. No. Loser is found in whenever the that's right. Anything is what? Age difference only, no? Fundamental pathology is same. Mineralization may issue hai. Mac Murray's is done for meniscal tear. All that list you must be sure, doctor. Antidroyer, pivot shift, Leckman. Between the three, which is most sensitive is examiner's question. Leckman is lucky MCQ, if you know the answer, most sensitive. Because Leckman karne ke liye aap 20 degrees flexion karna padta. So that's the reason it is more sensitive. Then posterior tibial sag and posterior doyer is for posterior cruciate. Even reverse pivot and quadriceps active test. Then McMurray aptly are for meniscus, valgus varus for collateral ligament is what you have to be sure about. What is a sequestrum is the question. Dead bone surrounding granulation tissue is basically called the sequestrum. And fracture involving only the cortex is called green stick. Very easy question. Cubitus varus typically occur in supracondylar. And extracapsular fracture of the neck of femur, what is a common complication? Once more, intracapsular, extracapsular, you must know 10 differences both sides of the table. I don't want to once more give it in the notes of this explanatory booklet because it's there in every book, right? But actually today we did not give explanations because thoda late ready hua food. So that's the reason. Yeah. Khan is asking which subject next week? Raju, what is the next week subject? Jara pucho beta. Next week subject is kahan se hota? Are you happy about TNPG? TNPG, UPPG. Because abhi mai creative questions diye to aapko heart fail ho jayega. So TNPG, UPPG, previous questions of that subject will be a good ground for discussion. Ultimate examining mein wahi hota hai. So yesterday some students called and said, sir, kal ka paper to aapne, you have killed us unnecessarily. Our high spirits, we are now hoping that we are going to get seat. Suddenly ye kya ho gaya sir, aapka mutation a gaya. Last before week, Wednesday, you are conducting simple question paper. Aaju baaju ke state se, yaha idhar idhar se questions leke conduct kar rahe. 30-40 questions, creative is okay. Not 150, hey Krishna, Mukunda, Murari, the way Arjun says, I can't see the Vishwarupa kind of a thing. So we will try to conduct more modest papers. But 40-50, we will create something which is little measurable. Then, yeah, Shaz is complimenting good papers, good. So doctor, most common complication if you take intracapsular become a vascular necrosis and non-union. Most common of extracapsular becomes malunion is what you need to basically remember. What is the subject is? Pediatrics. Yeah. So prepare well and come and let's have a good fight. Then intervertebral disc prolapse. What is the most common site? Generally it is the L4 to L5. B. quervains, tenosynovitis may. What is this test called as? Finkelstein's test, as all of you know. Abductor pollicis longus, extensor pollicis brevis are the two important tendons which are involved. What are other names of B. quervain, doctor? Blackberry thumb, Geber's thumb, washerwoman's sprain, radial styloid, tenosynovitis. Mother's wrist, mummy's thumb. Sometimes examiner khel sakta. Synonyms say. So synonyms, antonyms nahi hai, eponyms. You need to be sure. Then, what is treatment of congenital dislocation? Salter's osteotomy. As you can see, our whole idea of congenital dislocation hip mein kya hota hai? Femoral head ke contour ko acetabular roof must match. So you should increase the depth of the acetabular roof in order to fit and contain the femoral head. For that either pelvis may thoda repair kar sakte ya head of the femur may thoda repair kar sakte, kuch bhi karke head ko leke acetabulum ke under bithana. That is the whole idea. That is what you do in different types of osteotomies. So this is basically called the Salter's osteotomy, innominate osteotomy.